emergency systems. Re-readying engines. Stage one propulsion is nominal. Beginning pitch over.
As you just saw, we have had successful liftoff of the R3D2 mission on Electron. Coming up soon, Electron will go through a series of mission milestones in quick succession, including main engine cutoff, or MECO, where the 9 Rutherford engines on Electron's first stage will shut down. Shortly after this, we'll see stage 1 separation, followed by ignition of the vacuum-optimized Rutherford engine on Electron's second stage. Following second stage ignition, Electron's fairing will separate, revealing the payload in preparation for deployment approximately 50 minutes from now.
Next cue. Minutes remaining. Stage one propulsion still nominal.
AOS Chatham Station.
CR2 successful. Engines throttled down, 20 seconds remaining. Entering burnout detect mode. Stage one, MECO. Stage suppression succeeded. Ignition on stage two, propulsion is nominal.
Right down the center line.
And there you have it. Confirmation that Electron's main engines have shut down as planned. We've had stage one separation, and the stage two engine has successfully ignited. Electron is now carrying on to orbit.
Successful transfer orbit. And stage separation.
All right, you heard the call. The kick stage has now separated from Electron's second stage. Approximately 40 minutes from now, the Curie engine on the kick stage will ignite and circularize to a 425-kilometer orbit for payload deployment. Because we won't be receiving video of today's payload deploy, this animation shows what the deployment of the R3D2 spacecraft will look like. Once the kick stage reaches a precisely planned point in orbit, the R3D2 payload will separate from the kick stage approximately 40 minutes from now. At this point, the mission will be complete. Here at Rocket Lab, we don't just go to orbit, we deploy satellites with exquisite accuracy thanks to this kick stage. The small but agile upper stage is equipped with cold gas thrusters that enable precision pointing. It means we can orient the kick stage to just the right position, then deploy our customer satellites to exactly the right orbit. So with that, we're going to end today's webcast. Thank you to DARPA and our mission partners for choosing to launch on Electron. Here at Rocket Lab, we're opening access to space to improve life on Earth, and today's mission to test new space technologies is another successful step in achieving that goal. Stay tuned to Rocket Lab's social media channels for mission highlights from today's launch, as well as confirmation of payload deployment. So wherever you are in the world, thank you for joining us.